different types of joints used in a robotic arm. Basically, we can divide into three: a prismatic joint, second one a revolute joint, third one a ball and socket joint. Okay, first one is prismatic joint, which give a linear motion to the joint. Linear motion means sliding type joints, which gets axis parallel to the two links. And second one, revolute joint, we can classify it into different sections: rotational type, or revolving type, twisting type. And the third one is ball and socket joint, which also known as spherical joint. It's a three-dimensional joint. So, okay, we can detailly discuss these joints. Let's see prismatic joint first. Okay, in the figure you can see the prismatic joint. There is an input link there and an output link. You can see the output link can be moved inward and outwards, which actually it's a joint, but we can get a linear motion there. Prismatic joint actually represented by the alphabet letter P or sometimes L. Did you hear it? No. Okay. A prismatic joint provides linear sliding movement between the bodies. Linear motion ആണ് നമ്മൾ ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നത്. Used for forward and backward movements. In the second figure, you can see the variable distance which we can occur in a prismatic joint. When come to another type of prismatic joint, that is orthogonal joint. Similar to a linear joint, the input and the output are perpendicular to each other. While making the joint, we can move that output link through the input link. We can move the output link between the input links. You can see the diagram of an orthogonal prismatic joint. Okay. Now let's see different types of rotational joints. Revolute joints. First, we can see the rotational joint, which represented R. Rotation is perpendicular to the axis of input and the output link. You can see the figure of a rotational joint where input link and output link connected, but output link can be rotated with respect to input link. A three-dimensional figure is also there. You can find it. Second one is revolving type angular motion. Revolving type. Axis of rotation is parallel to the axis of rotation. Where input link, you can see the input link and the output link. It can rotate around the axis of input link, which will be the parallel to the axis of rotation. Okay. The next one is twisting, represented as V. Provides twisting motion between input and output links. Twisting means like this. Twisting, axis of rotation perpendicular to the output link. You can see the diagram of a twisting joint. Okay, and third important joint is ball and socket joint. Actually, it's a spherical joint, or we can say it's a three-dimensional joint. It can occur not only three-dimensional motions, but can larger range of motions can be occur. So for example, if you are using a joystick, different angle of rotations can be obtained while playing some video games, etc. So this is the figure for a ball and socket joint. You can see the axis of rotations, x axis, y axis, z axis, is the three dimensional motions. Other than three dimensional, you can occur different types of angle motions there. okay, that's the end of today's class. By taking a rewinding, we studied the definition of a robot, we find the basic structure of a robot arm, robot arm, and different types of joints. Okay, thank you, see you next class.